Oh, wow. See, when you're looking for a saguaro, you can't really touch these out in the desert here, but look at how white that is. That's perfect. And we got a small saguaro boot. Not in that good a shape, but look at this. Wow. There's still grass in there. Wow, look at that. Cool. That's a double saguaro boot. Very nice. And there's still, if you don't know what I'm talking about, it's basically a bird's nest. The birds dig into the cactus, and you could have an owl living in there, or cactus wren, all kinds of different birds can use that hole over time. But that is pretty cool. First one I've ever seen like that. Wow, look at that. That's awesome. I know people who are looking at this like, are you crazy? What the heck is that? Well, out here it's a big deal. Check this out. I just found that one right there. I missed it. So you got this one. And then I'm looking over here. We have another one, which is in bad shape. But it is a boot. So we'll put this one over here too. Well, let's see, what is this? Might have been another one. That one's no good. But that's pretty cool. That's the most I've seen in one cactus. Here's a palo verde. You see that thing in there? That's mistletoe. It's a parasite, actually. And it'll grow all over this thing and suck up the moisture, basically. All the nutrients, it'll take it away from the tree. And then I'll show you what it looks like when it kills the tree. And here's what it looks like when it kills the tree. And here's the parasite, all dead. It sucked up all the nutrients, killed the tree, and the saguaro will now grow a little bit faster. It just needed some shade to start, but that's pretty old, that one right there. But that's what it does. It kills the tree. Now you can see all these little clumps. They're all on most of the palo verdes. Some of them don't have any, luckily for them. Another way it helps kill it is it's so heavy that it will snap the branch and then it will die. This thing gets so heavy, it'll just break the branch. And it kills it slowly. And the only way you can actually stop it would be to just cut that branch right there, cut it off. Wherever there is one of those things, just cut the branch. And that's all you can do. I mean, look at that one. That has a lot of them on there. Anyway, that's your lesson for today. Mistletoe is bad. It just kills the host wherever it attaches itself to. And eventually, it ends up like that. Now, by the time I put this video up, it will be tomorrow, maybe. We're supposed to get rain tomorrow, but as you can see, it's very hazy back there. The clouds are everywhere. I did see some raindrops. It's possible we could get some rain tonight or later today. So instead of having dry air, we got a little humidity in the air. Well, we'll see what happens. People have been waiting for this rain for a long time. Here's a good example of the mistletoe. As you can see, it just attaches itself. And the only way to get rid of it would be just to cut the branch, basically. But I'm not sure if it already killed this thing or it just lost all its leaves because of the summer. Anyway, maybe I can help it if it is. We just get rid of this mistletoe here. Look at this one, a little one right there. Get rid of it. And here's a big one. Well, I can't get rid of them all. But that's how you would get rid of it, or stop it anyway. Big saguaro over there. But as I'm walking, I have to be careful not to step on any. Up there, the fruit is red now. You can see it better. Check it out. Nice and red. The birds had a nice meal with that. Check this out. You can tell they shot right through it. Let's see, no stain formula. Some idiot did this a long time ago in the desert. You'll find stuff like that out here that's really, really old. When people were allowed to just walk around and shoot stuff, I guess. Here's a really good example. The mistletoe, the weight of it just snapped us in the wind because of the weight. And now it's just dying. I don't see any on this tree. I don't even know how it gets on there. I'm sure I could look it up, but it's not good. Let's just put it that way.